Hey guys, Papa Pete back again today with another pickup video, joined by Charcoal in the Basket. And today I'm going to call it my pre-crash special. And it's all games from back when I was a kid. I shouldn't say really all necessarily from when I was a kid, but at least for systems that were out when I was a kid, some new things for them. I've got some stuff for my Atari 2600. I've got some Atari 2600 items. And I've also got some special homebrew games for my Intellivision system, the Intellivision OG, my absolute favorite system. Hence the Major League Baseball shirt on today. Anyway, Charcoal, are you all set? We're also going to have a craft beer, so stick around. Here we go.
Papa Pete, Papa Pete, the old ass gamer. Having grown up by the age of 50, you don't have to.
Coco wants to remind you to check out IntelevisionCollector.com for all your Intellivision collecting needs. Whether it's accessories, homebrews, or games from the original 125, check out IntelevisionCollector.com. All right, so Charcoal, before we start it all off, I'm going to have a craft beer. Today I got a craft beer I've never had before at all, but I'm very familiar with the brewery. It is Garrison Brewery in Halifax, Nova Scotia, right down at Pier 21, downtown Halifax, right on the water. And this one is Be the Change Blueberry Braggot. Very, very unique. It's a strong beer, 6.4% alcohol. And what it says is it's not quite a beer and not quite a mead. On the barcode right here, it says unbelievable. So let's check it out. Be the Change Blueberry Braggot. Oh, nice. All right, so let's check it out. Oh, this has actually got a color. A lot of the times a blueberry beer, I find, they look like a regular beer. You can't tell. Smell the aroma. Oh, I can smell the blueberry in it, though, that's for sure. But you can also see it in this one, in the color. That is a very unique flavor. That's what it says, like, it's not quite a beer, it's not quite a mead, it's sort of a combination of the two. And I really do enjoy it. It's great. You know, it's not something that I'm going to sit here and drink two or three of, probably, but to have one, really interesting to try it out. So, very happy to try that. 64-bit brought this for me from Halifax, and right on. Thanks a lot. I love trying different things like this. If you get the opportunity to try it out yourself, Be the Change, try it out. Right on. All right, guys, so I have three pretty amazing packages to open here, all nicely boxed up. I'm hoping everything's in really good condition. But first, before I get those, I'm going to show you something I picked up on a local buy and sell. Just it popped up on my feed on Facebook, and the opportunity was there to buy this. I've wanted one of these for such a long time. I have Intellivision ones, I have ColecoVision ones, I have Sega Genesis, I have NES, I have all kinds of different ones, but I never had an Atari Flashback. And I managed to pick an Atari Flashback 8 Gold. I got it for like $40, which was an amazing price, I thought. Right on it, it says it was a clearance for $80, which I know they did get cleared out at different times. But to pick it up for $40, they said in their ad they had only ever played it once. Well, it certainly looks like it, because everything is in it. Isn't that neat, huh, Charcoal? Everything was in it. Wireless controllers, which I don't know how they would work. But I'm really anxious to try it out. You can crawl right in that box, too. I don't know. That's good. But the thing about this one is HDMI. Of course, the wireless controllers, which I'm not real fussy about that. That's fine. But it's got 120 different games. And some of the games in this system are games that I've not actually even seen anywhere else. And the one I'm going to talk about specifically is I noticed that there's a copy of M Network Sea Battle on this one, which was never ever released. It's not one of the N-Network games that was released back in the 80s. There were 17 of them. I've got 15. I'm only missing Star Strike and Masters of the Universe. But Sea Battle is one of my all-time favorite games for the Intellivision system. So to be able to try that out on the... Yeah, I probably could have found it for emulation, found a ROM, but I had never done so. So to try it out like this, I'm really looking forward to that. And I'm sure there's probably other games on there as well, like Sword Quest, Waterworld, stuff like that. The Sword Quest games were what they were, right? But still, it's really kind of neat to go back and look at those games. Anyway, Atari Flashback 8, to pick one up for that price, how do you beat it? Right on. Hey, charcoal's abandoned me, so that's just fine, because just more space to move things around. I've got three boxes to open here, so let's go and listen to a little bit of RGC while I do it. Don't know what song I'm going to play. Doesn't really matter. Let's just play something great from RGC. Here we go. Super careful I open these boxes because I don't want to hit any of the packaging inside with my knife. And if you're ever shipping anything to anybody, it's a great idea to put a piece, little piece of cardboard just above the flap, or below, I should say below the flap when you close it. That way, if the blade does go in, it hits that piece of cardboard before it hits anything that you put in the package. Just a little tip. A lot of people do it. Some people do it. Some people don't. Then most times it doesn't matter as long as you're careful when you're opening it. But anyway, just little piece, something that I just thought of. My first package is something I also bought off, I believe it was Atari Age Marketplace. I found a fella who was selling some complete in box, Atari 2600 games. His name was John Black, and I had a great conversation with him after the fact. Really happy to get this game. He had tons of different games for sale. And all I'm going to say is the first time I bought from him. Gotta love this packaging, right? It's in great condition. Everything's inside here. It's got lots of shrink wrap. We're gonna pull it out, get rid of the box, and look at this. Sears Telegames. I've got a copy of Memory Match, which of course is Concentration, right? I'm quite sure that's what it is, right? Concentration. I love collecting the Sears Telegames games, just like I love collecting the Sears games for the Intellivision. But the Atari ones, I think I have like a dozen or so now, just picking away at them little by little. Some of them can be pretty expensive, but the thing about it is some of them people ask for exorbitant prices for them, and then you can turn around and find one for a more reasonable price. And that was the case with John. Given the condition and given what he charged me, for shipping included, I'm very happy with it, John. So thank you so much. Memory Match, another addition to my Atari 2600 Sears collection. You can never have too many Sears games. I just love them from back in the day. Anyway, let's move on to the next one. So next, I have some games that came, some homebrew games for my Intellivision collection. And I've been on a real kick for Intellivision homebrews. I just recently hosted the Intellivision Homebrew Awards for 2021 on the Atari Ace channel. I hosted it here on my YouTube channel. So the awards ceremony, first of all, there's a video that introduces all the nominees, lists them all out, and asks for you to go vote. But of course, the voting's over. We've had the awards ceremony that was last Friday, February 11th. So I'm filming. It was a week ago now. And it went really great. I was joined by Luke Boudreau, the Intellivision collector. Of course, one of the best Intellivision websites going. If you're looking for anything for your Intellivision collection, check out IntelliVisionCollector.com. He has a lot of homebrews for sale as well. He has a lot of ROMs you can buy for your Ultimate Flashback, for your LTO Flash, anything like that. Anyway, we had a great time. Jeff from Go Game Go joined us. Check out Go Game Go as well. Check out the live chats on Wednesday nights. We have a lot of fun those nights. And then every other Thursday he has a Nintendo show from 7 o'clock Central until 8 o'clock Central for the Nintendo show, and 7 o'clock Central until about 8:30, 9 o'clock for the general chats. Anyway, point is there were some amazing homebrews released for the Intellivision system in 2021, and the awards, the big winners this year were for digital and graphics, and it was a digital release only for graphics and sound, was The Sorrow of Gadland Thur. And then the biggest physical release was, man, it's incomparable, Intellivania. Game of the Year physical, best packaging, and best port. Intellivania by Matthew Keel. Fantastic game, released by Intellivision Revolution. Anyway, so I love collecting Intellivision homebrews. And I had to have one. This was nominated for lots of things this year on the Intellivision Homebrew Awards. It is from Collector Vision, and it finishes of the last wave. There was the Goon Enough. There was Gorf. I picked those up last fall, and now I have a copy of Death Race. And I don't know if you remember Death Race. Who was the game by Exidy, right? Death Race was an arcade game from back in the 70s, which is just as morbid as you would think, but the object was to drive around the screen running over people. And they made a port over to the Intellivision. Fantastically done. I really do like the boxes, the presentation that ColecoVision has done. They put out so many great products, predominantly Intellivision, but the ColecoVision and other systems. So anyway, very happy to have Death Race from ColecoVision. So now's my last pickup, and this is one of the absolute most fantastic companies in the homebrew and television community, and that is a box from William Muller at Electronite. I love the Electronite games, such huge, high quality, and I didn't get into them real early, so unfortunately there's a lot of games that I just didn't pick up. But I've been talking to them, I've done a couple videos on Indie Homebrew Spotlight. Make sure you check out my video series Indie Homebrew Spotlight. That is where the award ceremonies are, but it's also where I take a look at different indie homebrew games, not only for recent releases, but upcoming games and games from the past. Take a look at them. I've looked at some fantastic ones, and here is a couple more that I didn't know if I'd ever be able to get. They're wrapped up so well in shrink wrap here. Hopefully I can get this open. I'm going to use my knife, and I'm going to be very, very careful when I do it. Great packaging from Electronite, and what I mean packaging, not only packaging physically of the games, but packaging for shipping. I mean, they're very, very safely shipped. And here we go. First game is, look at this, I got a copy of Boulder Dash. Kind of been out of print for a little while. There might be a few more kicking around. I have missed that one. This is number 356 from Electronite. Real straight. I'm not that familiar with the game. I do know it's an arcade type game. It was released on several different systems back in the 80s. And I gotta check into it a little bit more closely. But very happy to have Boulder Dash in my collection finally. Fantastic game. I love it. And last but not least, doesn't get any better than this, the Carl Mueller Classic. I got D2K Arcade. I had DK Arcade. Thank you, C-Mart, for sending me that one. But I didn't have a copy of this. These are getting more and more difficult to get all the time. Donkey Kong, the original, I did it on the 125. I'll put a link to that in the comments below. What I thought about Coleco's version of Donkey Kong for the Intellivision. And then Carl Mueller came out and created DK Arcade and D2K Arcade to show what the Intellivision system could actually do. So extremely happy to finally have a copy of this one. I had the original, but man, this one's harder and harder to get all the time. If you have the opportunity to pick this up, by all means, you should grab it. Anyhow, man, fantastic. Well, guys, fantastic, incredible. How many more adjectives can I use? Additions to my Intellivision homebrew collection, plus to the Sears collection for the Atari 2600. Not to mention the fact, this baby right here, really glad to have that to add to my, console collection, flashback collection, we'll call it. So anyway, just an amazing set of pickups. Thank you so much for joining me today, spend a little bit of time with me. Don't forget to hit like, comment, subscribe, and you know, I'll probably be having some more pickups pretty soon, so I hope you join me again. Take care. Papa Pete, Papa Pete, the old ass gamer. Papa Pete, the old ass gamer. If you haven't grown up by the age of
15, what's up, nerdlings? It's Tom and Lacey of Do You Nerd.
And you're watching Papa Pete, the old guy gamer. What?